This is indeed a timely and very important conference at a very moment of the discussion on the post-2015 and also on the SDGs for the LDCs. It's very important because a number of issues we need to address are very complex, complicated, and they all are related to each other. And within 3 days, it's very difficult to exhaust all the discussions. And I think we bring in some critical elements that need to be discussed at national level, bringing together the various stakeholders from the government, the parliamentarian, the communities at different levels. And then to see fundamentally in number of countries looking at their development programs or plan, and then how it might be possible to bring the element we discuss here in on the post-2015. At the end, who are taking decision? Who are implementing the different recommendations? Is at national level. And then who will make a pressure to be accountable on what needs to be done and how it can be done is the various stakeholders, from the parliamentarian to the communities at various levels, being in urban area or rural area. What is important is that there is a call in many of the LDCs for a fundamental change. And then to bring in fundamental change, that means revisiting the different development program and project at various level. It's amazing how in those kind of forum, we do not put emphasis on energy issues. Energy is critical. Energy is fundamental. You cannot do anything without energy. You cannot improve agricultural sector without energy. If you have energy, you have water. If you have energy, you have food. If you have energy, you have job, because you can transform the products. You can transport the products. If you have energy, you have everything. It has to be at the core. It's a driver for what else you want to do. And unfortunately, we are not devoting too much attention on energy issues. Talking about increasing growth, how you can get growth without energy. And we discuss also the fact that in many LDCs, particularly in Africa or in West Africa, the average cost of electricity is 20 cents per kilowatt hour in the capital city. That means if you can get it, because this is not all the time, how can you attract any industrial sector to come in that context? In the rural area, it's about $1 per kilowatt hour. There's no way you can install any small-scale agro-industry in order to transfer agricultural product. And then if we are not looking fundamentally at those different aspects, the industrialization of many LDCs will be completely foreclosed. And it's timely to think about it. What are the options, the energy supply options, in the context of LDCs regarding their geographical, their economic, and then their sociocultural element? And then we do have a number of possibilities and potential and how to adequately address that issue. It's a big mistake to bring in the LDC issues and the SDGs. The SDGs is the fragmentation of number of issues. And then you take different issues, you look at what need to be done, what are the different goals. The issue and the problem of the LDCs is that all are interconnected. You cannot discuss water issues independently to the energy, independently to the agricultural, independently to the gender aspect. All are interrelated, is in a holistic basis. You cannot do a fragmentation. If you start doing the fragmentation, you will neglect some of the fundamental elements. And that is why it is not wise to bring that We have to have in mind that there is a particularity for LDCs, and this particularity should be maintained to have an holistic approach rather than having a fragmentation approach. Mm-hmm.